Hey guys, welcome to our talk show. I'm Cambry.
And I'm Carter.
And Avery's not here yet, but she'll come.
Eventually, probably.
Are we? Okay, I want to make sure we're getting audio. It's just very quiet.
Yes, because...
What if it's too quiet?
It's not too quiet.
It's fine.
Okay.
So, this is our Edward gets hot too.
But he's also kind of creepy. Like he's
well, that's because they have to make him super pale.
Because he's a vampire.
Yeah, if he wasn't so pale.
Yeah, he just looks like he's about to die.
Well, he is technically dead.
Well, like, he looks like he's decomposing.
Yeah, I get that. But yeah, so. Divorced. Her mom lives in Arizona with her, I can't remember if it's her boyfriend or her, it's her new husband. And they have to leave to go on the road for her husband's baseball thing. So Bella has to move back to Forks in Washington to live with her dad, Charlie, which, by the way, I love Charlie.
I feel like we're getting kind of less and less of a brief summary.
Yeah, anyway, so then she meets these vampires, and she falls in love with Edward, and she becomes best friends with Jacob, and just lots of stuff.
Jacob is not a vampire.
Jacob's a werewolf, but not at first. He turns into a werewolf. You'll see. It's great. Okay, anyway. So yeah, there's a lot of drama between Jacob and Edward and Bella's high school friends. Drama between the werewolves and vampires. It's a lot.
Yes.
But yeah, great movies. Now we should rank them.
Okay. First, say, what are the movies in order?
What?
Like, what are the movies? Like, what are they called?
Okay, well, is Breaking Dawn Part 1. The fifth one is Breaking Dawn Part 2. So, yeah.
Personally, Eclipse is my favorite movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, Eclipse is so underrated, though.
Literally.
I saw when... Okay, so when Netflix first came out with the Twilight movie, like, first put them on there, everybody was obsessed with them and, like, ranking them. And people put the Eclipse last.
Literally.
I'm like, that was a good one. The second one I didn't really like quite as much because Edward wasn't in it that much.
Yeah.
It was, I mean, it was still good. And, like, there's a reason why Edward wasn't in it, but it was just, it was off.
Yeah, I feel like the second one's probably my least favorite.
Yeah.
Little Edward's in it.
Yeah, it just, there wasn't as much drama, I feel like. Not as much romance. Like, I don't know.
Not as much happened in that one.
Yeah, it was. It all revolved around one thing. Like, I don't know. It just was my least favorite. But, so yeah, if I had to rank them, I'd probably put Twilight as my number one. My number two would probably be Breaking Dawn Part 1, which I used to hate that one. Like, not hate it, but it was my least favorite when I was younger because I thought it was weird, because it kind of is.
Yeah.
It's kind of creepy, but now it's probably my second favorite. Third favorite. I was obsessed with Breaking Dawn Part 2 when it first came out.
Me too. And then
I was obsessed with it.
I
watched it so many times. It's like a great movie though, but I just like the other ones more.
I really love the whole saga.
Yeah.
But I just, like, I don't hate any of them.
No, I love all of them.
I love a few of them more than the other.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't. Breaking Dawn Part 1, something about it, just like, that's the movie where Bella and Edward get married, and then there's drama with Jacob, lots of drama with Jacob, because, spoiler, Bella gets pregnant by Edward, which, like, how does that happen, because Edward's, like, dead, and, like, his body's literally rock, like, it's hard, like,
so how is she pregnant?
Like, what does he have to make her pregnant? You know what I mean? Like that. Yeah, that doesn't really make sense. But yeah, so that's like really dangerous for her. And yeah. But it works out in the end. Oh my gosh, there's Carson again.
Oh my gosh, Grant. I feel like Breaking Dawn.
Look at Peyton. Little trick with us. Should I say it?
Yes.
It's fine. If you haven't seen the Twilight movies by now, you live under a rock, so, like, I don't care that I'm spoiling it. Anyway. So, Alice is Bella, or, is Edward's sister, but none of them are actually, like, related. Just, yeah.
It's like
an adult. a doctor now, which, like, go him, self-control.
Right.
Because they feed off blood. If you didn't get
like,
that.
Imagine being around them.
I know, he is. And he's like, oh, I love Carlisle. He's really hot, too. Like,
very attractive.
Yeah. So then he turned Edward when he was dying. So all of their family he saved because they were dying. So that's the only reason they're vampires is because Esme is like their mom figure. So Carlisle and Esme are like together. Alice, who can like see the future kind of. Then she's with Jasper, who can what's his deal? He can make you, he can control your emotions. And then Emmett, who is freakishly strong, is with Rosalie. She's just really beautiful, but she doesn't really have a power, like, thing. So yeah. And then Edward and Bella, obviously. Bella, when she's a vampire, she gets the power of, like, a shield, so she can shield people from pain, which is really cool. Anyways, yeah. Favorites is Carlisle.
I like
he's nice. Yeah, he's so nice.
Gives off a really good vibe.
Yeah, I love him. Jacob.
I was gonna say Jacob.
Yeah, I love Jacob.
I mean, how can you not?
Literally. And he's cute too. Oh my gosh. Alice. I love she just kind of pisses me off sometimes.
Yeah, same. Like, she's one of the main characters, but she's not my favorite.
She's just like, I don't know, like, it's not that I don't like her, because I like her, but yeah. Like, she's just not my favorite.
She makes me so mad with some of her choices. Just like, stop.
And like, sometimes the way she like, breathes and stuff is kind of annoying.
Yeah, it's just like, get over yourself.
Yeah. So she's Yeah. Yes. So, those are probably my favorites.
Same.
Yeah. My least favorite. Oh, I don't know. Okay, well, I hate James, who's in the first movie. He's a vampire. I hate Victoria, who's in the first and the third movie. If you watch the movies, you'll get it. I hate them. And yeah. Oh shoot. What's the main guy's name on the Volturi?
Oh,
I know it. Like, I just there's like one of them's Gaius, one of them is, shoot, what's the main one's name? Gosh, that pisses me off. I need to figure it out.
Just look it up really quick.
Okay.
What? We're looking it up. We will get the answer.
Whoops. It definitely is.
I think so.
There's like, because there's Gaius, and Aro's like the main guy. Okay. I don't, he's creepy as frick.
He's really freaking scary.
I don't like it.
He just gives me the chills, and I don't like
he's
it.
He's like, ew, the way, what movie is it? I think it's Breaking Dawn Part 2, where he like laughs really creepy.
Yeah. That made me want to throw up.
Literally,
like,
I'm not, like, we're not exaggerating. Really ugly too.
Oh my god.
Like, his hair is really long, but it's like slick. Oh, it's so ugly.
Yeah, it kinda, like,
it's scary. Oh my gosh. I also love I basically love all of the werewolves. Like, they're all attractive too.
Yeah.
I love Seth. He's so cute. He's so sweet. Should we, like, roll it?
No, that's what we should have done at the beginning.
Yeah,
we can roll out.
Okay, so that will conclude our Twilight review
episode.
I rate all of them 6 stars out of 5. Because I love them.
I'll just give them a 4.9.
Okay,
sorry.
I'm kidding. It's fine. Okay, anyway.
Thank you for doing it.
Go well. The red button on top.